Today's date is the 13th of December, 2016. It is now 1:06 p.m. The military minded is now 13:06. I was just reading an email that I get from the local Democrats. I am not a registered Democrat. I voted for Trump. I wasn't dumb enough to vote for Obama first time nor the second. Rush Limbaugh, thank you for your words of wisdom. So, now, I received this about 7 or so. I missed it. It came out to me on the 11th. I was cleaning out my email last night and came across this. Anyway, it says, Bruce, the Dispatch, Monroe County Democrat Party, the Dispatch, acronym M. Mike C. Charlie D. Delta P. Papa, news to pursue and use. Well, we're going to pursue and use. It says, Bruce, the Dispatch, upcoming events, a very special invitation from the Monroe County Commissioners and staff. Please join us to thank Commissioner Iris Kiesling for her years of service to our community. Tuesday, December the 13th, 2016 at 3 p.m. Military minded, that's 1500 hours. Third floor of the Monroe County Courthouse. That's where it's at, but it says just simply third floor. Iris Kiesling. Here is Mrs. Iris Kiesling's information for those that would like to make any further inquiries for what I'm about to say. She has been in office since about 1996. Thank God she's leaving. The reason that I'm posting this is honestly, I will present what I've got to say, and maybe others will agree with me, maybe they won't. In this college town, I kind of doubt too many people will, but we'll do it anyway. Now, I didn't move here until about 2002-2003. Now, Mrs. Kiesling came into office about 1996 or so. The POW/MIA Veterans War Memorial Monument, 80 or so feet from their window. I'll post pictures with this here on Facebook. Was created in or about May or so, 1991. It was a community project. There's a big plaque there. I'll do my best to post pictures of it here. Now, it was also put in about the same time with the same effort of the one that's at the IU football stadium, the Memorial Stadium there on the, that'll be the west facing side of the stadium with the pom-poms or the bow fours and the now bow of the ship, of a ship. It is for the dedication of seemingly of the USS Indianapolis. My salute to Nola Gay and the rest. Nonetheless, that was put there. The plaque says there behind it, dedicated September the 11th, 1991. Now, as far as I can tell, they keep that place up when they stop flying the flags. They're on the top stadium looking like somebody stuck it on the back of an SR-71 took off. But anyway, we are talking about IU. So, nonetheless, this one particular argument is about the POW/MIA Vietnam Veterans War Memorial there at the Courthouse Square on the which would be west-facing side of the square. Now, mind you, I'm not a Vietnam vet. My family, my stepfather, United States Marine Corps, served 3 tours. 1 tour he did as identifying bodies and writing letters home. Incredibly good man. His brother, Bev, was a tunnel rat. Was quite a messed up individual. And is buried near Bowling Green, Kentucky. He died a few years ago. I have other friends and family. that were exposed to Agent Orange have had numerous health problems, uncles, and so on. Now, and known quite a few, and made friends with a few. One not too long ago, Mr. Ron Smarco was actually part of doing fishing groups for vets, for disabled vets. I don't know if he's still doing that. Nick Thill, Baits and Tackle was one of the groups he was established with. Anyway, good guy. Now, as for this monument memorial, as the pictures will show, Mrs. Kiesling wasn't elected until 2006 as commissioner. So we'll just stay on that for now. Now, in 1996 or thereabouts, the lights went bad on that monument memorial, 80 so feet from their office on the west side of the building, which the pictures will show. Now, the lighting went bad. They gutted it and just left them sand-filled holes. For whatever reason, that's what they decided to do. Now, I'm not certain in what time the vets gave up on trying to argue with to try to get it replaced and get the money and so on, considering the group project. I never, as far as I know, never met the actual people that actually physically put it there. I understand most of the fellows are since deceased or since gone and no longer a part of the upkeep. The county took control somewhere between 95 and 97. Mrs. Kiesling took office in 1996. From 1996 until 2010, it was left look like the pictures show, which I thought was rather disrespectful in the least, considering that she had, amongst the rest of them, authority to do something and perceivably ultimately ignored it, and it left like it shows for a very long time. Now, I moved to Bloomington in 2003 or so. Now, in about that time, like I said, I didn't even know the place existed until I noticed and so on until years later. Let's see here, I started making notifications in and about, I believe, starting in 2004, I think it was. 2006 is when I started making more inquiries into it. I actually ran into Evan By once. I actually talked to Peggy Welch, I believe it was, at once about it. Let's see here, who else? I tried to even communicate with Indiana University to get them to respond, to help get the county to do something, asking their basketball team or the Indianapolis Colts for that fact. I have no respect for either one of them. I don't give a damn about the sports. As I understand, the same groups actually did try to do the same thing with them, but obviously the state seemed didn't give a shit because seemingly they were all too willing to build the football stadium to help the Colts. Well, the Colts could have bought the thing and paid for it themselves. Meanwhile, the product, supplied goods, is made in China, sold back to America. There's people paying to use the stadium, and it's taxed back to keep it up. So their taxes are paying for it, and they're getting screwed two ways. Meanwhile, those football teams could have paid for it and owned it. But nonetheless, just as a point, they ignored those petitions to try to help get that taken care of. Coach Cream and Jeff Jarrett, pretty much it's the exact same thing. The county and the city, when they were trying to buy the and create and develop the Twin Lakes ballpark, like I said, I don't care about the damn sports. I don't give a shit. It's just not me. But nonetheless, Coach Cream and Jared's team, people, friends, the team, IU basketball, all of them were petitioned to help. They didn't care. Same scenario with that. The city bought and paid for the place. It's tax-backed. It's putting a hurt on the local community that has to compete for it as their taxes paying to pay for it. Nonetheless, they use the foot or the basketball star as a, hey, look, we bought this and paid this. The 6 foot idiot's here. Let's see everybody show up and, hey, it's okay. It's just my opinion of it. I really don't care. Nonetheless, the guy makes millions. The team makes millions. IU could have bought and paid for the damn thing, but they didn't. They used the stars to placate unreasonable abuse of nationalism. It doesn't make sense to me, economically either. It's stupid. It does more harm to the economics than it does good. It's a fact. Nonetheless, Mrs. Kiesling, along with Joyce Poling and the rest of them, Mark Stoops even, Patrick Stover didn't come until later, but nonetheless, all the same individuals making and having the period in time that even when I threw the dirt on the county commissioner, the sand on the county commissioner's desk to get their attention on the matter, it was a deer in a headlight look. Really? You're concerned? Wow. No joke. That's literally about the response you got. I was seriously wondering, are these people smoking something that I'm not smelling that shouldn't be even for me? Smoking crack in the back room? That's no joke. That's serious. That's about the mentality that I could see in their eyes. But nonetheless, I don't smoke, use needles, and so on. That ain't me either. Anyway, the point here is even the pot smoker would be smarter than that, honestly. Now, but as for this lady here that I'm trying to talk with, they're trying to give this award to or recognition. She had four terms in office to influence an argument amongst her peers. Hey, we have a monument outside that we're actually responsible for because we were given, it was given to us, turned over by the vets. Why haven't we bothered fixing it? It's only 80 feet from our window. The story goes, this is what happened. I was trying to make petitions on it, and I tried it in every facet I could think of. They ignored emails, they ignored me coming to the office to say or do anything. Up to the point I threw it on the county commissioner's desk in between 2007 2008. It was entered about there. Now, I was at the public library and I was watching videos at the time. I was watching the Love Me While I Was Gone, and I was going through divorce and I was losing my own kids through a divorce because of medical and so on and so forth, and adoptions and so on. And obviously the video upset me because it made me think of my own military experience a little bit, what shadow and little bit there was. Nonetheless, the deep root in family and military, it struck a nerve. Well, the point was when the guy's holding the redhead and the little one, he's hugging the little girl. And I just shut off the machine, walked back over to the courthouse, took my hat off, took the sand, put it in my hat, walked up to the third floor, threw it on the county commissioner's desk. And as the commissioner's asking him, yelling at him, say, well, what the fuck your problem? Why didn't you fix it? And Mrs. Poling was the lady there at the time, and she started to open up her mouth how they didn't have the money. I told her in so much of a words, I think pretty much my exact words were, keep your forked tongue behind your goddamn teeth. I believe that's exactly what I said, if I remember correctly. Short of the emotion that was about ready to open up the window and throw her and the other fellow in the room out the third story window, Mr. Patrick Stover's come in the room and says, you're no closer to pretty much getting done with this by your action. That's a gist of what he said, saying that it didn't make a difference. And I told him, you didn't give a damn about he didn't no more give a damn about that monument or more than a man in a move. I think that was about what I said. And I left. It was, the next step was pretty much throw his ass out to the window and knock his teeth down his throat. So I knew I was already going to jail. Didn't make a difference, so I didn't want to necessarily add on the charge of me beating the piss out of somebody. So I just simply left. That's unreasonable. So the point is that obviously I got arrested, and I spent about 6 months in jail. They wouldn't show up for court. Basically, it was time serving. They let me go. Honestly, I'm not surprised that they would hide. They didn't have the balls to show up to court. They didn't want to give me the chance to argue in court. Right or wrong or indifferent. That's how much of a coward and no fortitude that they have. It showed me. Now, it did not get fixed, interesting enough, for another 2 years. And that came from me going back. They even tried to use the ploy to be able to keep me from going back by trying to have a restraining order so that I couldn't go back to the county commissioner's office. I ignored that. I didn't give a damn. I kept going back, kept going back, kept going back, kept going back. Finally, I don't remember who, where it did. I think I even tried to make a call to Mr. John McCain's office asking him for intervention. Hey, you know, sir, I know you. I think if the conversation was, I know you would actually care, I think it was. I think it was shortly right after that they actually did fix it. So maybe it was him chewing on somebody's ass that finally got something done. It was that pathetic that they just absolutely refused. And they were having Veterans Day and so on. They had, and people just simply walked by it. I was shocked to watch as they were holding and having taps and ceremonies and everything else, and they seemingly nobody seemed to even notice. It's like, my God, are all these people on drugs? What the hell's in a water supply? That was a quick thought. But whatever. So as far as her wanting to, the community wanting to uphold her, no, absolutely not. In all due respect to the office that she holds, there should actually be a strong petition to make sure she doesn't get any sort of recognition. There should be absolutely no pension whatsoever. They should hold her to a degree of almost a field grade Article 15 to keep her from getting anything. I mean, seriously. At the rate of which they still today actively deny physical claims amongst Vietnam era veterans for things, and not limited to still the drug testing, chemicals testing, chemical warfare, a lot of the Ancient Orange stuff is still rejected. They're still dealing with it. Not to mention the whole psychotronics issue that was still around and going on right around the Church Committee of 1975, ran all around the time of the fall of Saigon. So as to say that, you know, the point here is that stuff's still active. And people that are getting it now, from where the testing or confusion will start with there is an actual issue of being used, subsequently post-fact environmental probability is just as great today as it would have been there in another the other context, post-JFK, within the Church Committee in 1975 to 1978. Oddly enough, John Kerry went to Japan in 2013. The Metatata Convention was signed. It really doesn't mean anything because it didn't have a true origin as a true treaty. So it was pretty much ignored. Literally. And then all about the same year, 2013, also, interesting enough, the FCC created this new inquiry, Notice of Inquiry, Doctrine 1384, supposed to evaluate all frequencies. All. Not just one, not just cell phones. All. So one would have answered for the other, which would have done, which they ignored. Basically, it's Bill Clinton's I'm Sorry for Human Exploitation Experiments and Blind Experiments. This is 1996. The Telecommunication Act works great. What's stock in Blueberry or Blackberry or Buttberry or whatever it is? I don't own one, don't want one. But just as a make as a point. Psychotronic victims for a long. So as to say of even where active debates that I'm doing with that, just as a reference of where they were supposed to hold this new meeting that I tried to do, they didn't even show up to do the right one. Only she showed up with one lawyer. The Board of Health didn't come. Angie Purdy didn't come. David Schilling and the rest of them, none of them. Not even the doctors. Hell, the arrangements for Congressman Todd Young, they didn't even do right. So he didn't show. But she did. My own representative didn't even show. Maybe because I knew that I was going to bring this subject up about the Vietnam Veterans Memorial that I came in and threw a fit about. Maybe they were too cowardly to even argue the point historically for that. So, there's my spill. I don't agree her getting any recognition, anything positive. In my opinion, she doesn't deserve it. Not in retrospection for what that is. Grant you, they fixed, finally, that monument boil. They took out all the original lighting, put new poles up, but they seemingly didn't put up the right configuration of poles. They put two level poles, American flag, state flag, and then decided after a complaint, they just simply didn't bother putting on all one new one like they said they were going to in another video. They actually just put the state flag below the POW flag. I think they actually removed it. Now, they keep switching it back and forth, but that's not a flag code. Not in the right configuration. They don't care. They honestly don't. One more point on that is right after it was fixed in 2010, about the time that Dark Horse Marine Corps was fighting it out in Afghanistan, November the 11th is when they rededicated 2010. There was the wind chimes area, which I'll post the pictures of when I can figure out how to get it all on here. There was graffiti, what looked like whiteout or some sort of magic marker, permanent marker or something, of the Gang 13 signs on it. It took me about a total of 5 years to get them to just simply take a wire brush and clean it off and put the steel cover back on it. They repeatedly refused to keep up the lights on the wind chimes after that point. They didn't replace the wind chimes with wind chimes lighting. They removed the ground lighting and put them above, and then added the poles and rededication. It took me for a while to get them to argue to be able just to keep and replace and update the lighting with that, because they didn't care. So, as a point that of just for that one there, relevant for the Cold War, for the Vietnam area, for the Vietnam veterans, like I said, I'm not a Vietnam vet, but as far as I'm concerned, honestly, they should treat Mrs. Kiesling and all the county commissioners that actually were up to that date, that had every one of them, they should do like they do for Jane Fonda, for Hanoi Jane. First, they should do outdoor pissers with the configuration of their face for guys to walk by. Sorry, ladies. Maybe they could do one for the ladies so they can squat. But they're for the guys, they ought to put a stone figure for a pisser so they can walk by so they can piss in their face for it, including Iris Kiesling. That's exactly what I think. So, point here, Mrs. Iris Kiesling, I'm glad to see you go, because you didn't even do a follow-through, which your own lawyer said you were going to do with the meetings with I. You just proved a point to me that you were probably one of the worst politicians that I've ever seen. Glad you're going.